happened one day near December's end. Two neighbors called on an old-time friend, and they found his shop so meager and mean, made gay with 1,000 boughs of green. And Conrad was sitting with a face ashine when he suddenly stopped as he stitched a twine. And he said, "Old friends, at dawn today, when the cock was crowing the night away, the Lord appeared in a dream to me. And he said, 'I'm coming, your guest, to be.' So I've been busy with feet astir, strewing my shop with branches of fir. The table is spread and the kettle is shined, and over the rafters the holly is twined. And now I wait for my Lord to appear, and listen closely so I will hear his step as he nears my humble place. And I open the door and look on his face." So his friends went home and left Conrad alone, for this was the happiest day he had known. For long since his family had passed away, and Conrad had spent many a sad Christmas day. But he knew, with the Lord as his Christmas guest, this Christmas would be the dearest and best. So he listened with only joy in his heart, and with every sound he would rise with a start, and look for the Lord to be at his door, like the vision he had a few hours before. So he ran to the window after hearing a sound, but all that he could see on the snow-covered ground was a shabby beggar whose shoes were torn and all of his clothes were ragged and worn. But Conrad was touched and went to the door, and he said, "Your feet must be frozen and sore. I have some shoes in my shop for you, and a coat that will keep you warmer too." So with grateful heart, the man went away. But Conrad noticed the time of day, and he wondered what made the Lord so late, and how much longer he'd have to wait. When he heard a knock, and he ran to the door, but it was only a stranger once more. A bent old lady with a shawl of black, with a bundle of kindling piled on her back. She asked for only a place to rest, but that was reserved for Conrad's great guest. But her voice seemed to plead, "Don't send me away. Let me rest for a while on Christmas Day." So Conrad brewed her a steaming cup and told her to sit at the table and sup. But after she left, he was filled with dismay, for he saw that the hours were slipping away. And the Lord had not come as he said he would. And Conrad felt sure he had misunderstood. And out of the stillness he heard a cry, "Please help me and tell me, where am I?" So again he opened his friendly door and stood disappointed as twice before. It was only a child who had wandered away and was lost from her family on Christmas Day. Again Conrad's heart was heavy and sad, but he knew he should make the little girl glad. So he called her in and wiped her tears and quieted all her childish fears. Then he led her back to her home once more. But as he entered his own darkened door, he knew that the Lord was not coming today, for the hours of Christmas had passed away. So he went to his room and knelt down to pray. And he said, "Dear Lord, why did you delay? What kept you from coming to call on me? For I wanted so much your face to see." When soft in the silence, a voice he heard, "Lift up your head, for I kept my word. 3 times my shadow crossed your floor. 3 times I came to your lonely door. For I was the beggar with bruised cold feet. I was the woman you gave something to eat. I was the child on the homeless street. 3 times I knocked, 3 times I came in, and each time I found the warmth of a friend. Of all the gifts, love is the best. I was honored to be your Christmas guest."
suit to put on for fun. And then I was like, you know what, I'm just going to leave this on. And I realized how heavy the arm was on my bow. Anyways, we're so happy to be here today. We hope to get you into the holiday spirit. And we're going to play a bunch of my original tunes, along with our favorite Christmas songs. And this next one's called La Tension.
Frozen turkeys. She kept sorting them and flipping and pulling through. She said to the stock boy, she said, do these get any bigger? He said, no, they're dead. Ladies and gentlemen, Emily Flack.
From now on,
folks I know all written in a book. And every year when Christmas comes, I go and take a look. And then I realize that these names are a part, not of the book they're written in, but really from my heart. For each name stands for someone who has crossed my path sometime. And in the meeting, they become the rhythm in each rhyme. And while it sounds fantastic for me to make this claim, I really feel that I'm composed of each remembered name. And while you may not be aware of any special link, just meeting you has changed my life a lot more than you think. For once I've met somebody, the years cannot erase the memory of a pleasant word or of a friendly face. So never think my Christmas cards are just a mere routine of names upon a list forgotten in between. For when I spend a Christmas card that is addressed to you, it is because you're on the list that I'm indebted to. For I am but a total of the many folks I've met, and you happen to be one of those I prefer not to forget. And whether I've known you for many years or few, in some ways you have a part in shaping things I do. And every year when Christmas comes, I realize anew the best gift life can offer is meeting folks like you. May the spirit of Christmas that forever endures leave its richest blessing in the hearts of your and yours. Now, in your program, you may see that Eddie Glenn is your featured vocalist. Many of you will know Eddie from various Drake productions. He was the crazed Frenchman in Spamalot. He's a dancer, he's been in White Christmas and so on, but somehow Eddie got tangled up with a viral infection and had a serious reaction and ended up in hospital, all swelled up. He's okay now, he's taking care of himself. So we had to find a special performer to take his place. No stranger to a Drayton platform. He's currently on stage as Curtis the Thug in Sister Act. And right here on this stage, you'll also recall him from shows like Canadian Legends, Legends of Rock and Roll, and he was Javert in Les Miserables. As my cousin says, less miserable. He even went with the Broadway tour, the Canadian tour of Jesus Christ Superstar to Broadway. And he is a lovely guy. He came in. It was either him or director Alex Moustakas, and we chose him. He's on my Christmas list. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Lee Siegel.
Outside.
I gotta go away.
Oh, baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has been
so damn
nice.
I'll hold your hands, they're just like
my
us.
Starts to
beautiful, what's your heart? Just listen to the fireplace door. Beautiful, please don't scurry. Put some records on while I pour.
The neighbors might think
it's bad out there.
Say, what's in this drink?
No cats to be had out there.
I wish I knew how.
Your eyes are like starlight now. I'll take your hat, gee, your hair looks
I
well.
I ought to say no, no,
you
no.
You mind if I move it
at
closer?
At least I'm gonna say that twice.
What's the sense of hurt if I cry?
I really can't stay.
Summer we quickly.
Something must go.
Maybe it's cold outside.
But thanks for the show.
Maybe it's cold outside.
This evening has been.
So your lips are delicious.
Come on, hey, just a cigarette, Mom.
Never such a little bit more.
I gotta get home.
Just use the phone out there.
Just lend me your coat.
It's up to your knees out there.
Oh, it's really been grand. What's happening?
How can you do this thing to me?
It's bound to be taught to
you. Think about a life lost soul. Roasting on an open fire. animals. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. Well, they know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. How about this band, ladies and gentlemen? It's been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. Have a beautiful holiday, everyone.
Not bad for a fill-in. Oh, yes, we're all getting our greetings in our various ways. Remember the old carol, "Here We Come A-Wassailing"? You have to be older to remember that. Wassail is a salutation, meaning to your health. And it's also the name of a hot, spiced ale that is used especially in Great Britain for the drinking of healths at Christmas time. And often there is an ornate silver bowl, and it's a wassail bowl, and it's filled with the wassail drink and carried from house to neighboring house as the bearers go a wassailing. At each house, a toast is drunk to the health of every member of the household. After the fifth or sixth house, toasts are often drunk to the furniture.
Thank you.
Featured artist who gave Terry Fox one of those great memories of Cape Breton when he was running his marathon across Canada. And so that show will be back again next summer on the Drayton schedule. She's an accomplished fiddler, stepper. She's recorded many CDs, by the way, some will be available in the lobby, and she has consented to come out after the show and sign them if you would like some unique Christmas stocking stuffers. But before I let you go to intermission where you want to get your smooth and delicious premium ice cream, we're going to have a fiddle number here that'll rip it and warm us right up and make us want that ice cream. Now, this is a number made famous by Charlie Daniels. In fact, it's always been played by a man. And now we have kind of recreated that. We've got a she-devil now. Play us and rip us right through The Devil Goes Down to Georgia. Oh,
down to Georgia, she was looking for a soul to steal. She was in a bind because she was way behind and swimming to make a deal. She gave a price as a young man saw on the fiddle and playing it hot. And the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I bet you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil her due. I bet fiddle of gold against your soul because I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet you're gonna wreck because I'm the best that's ever been." Johnny Rats, no fiddle boy, no fiddle, fiddle boy. Just cause my wish in Georgia and the devil deals your cards. If you win, you got the shining fiddle, win the ball. When you lose, the devil gets the star.
to show, and fire flew from her fingertips as she roughened up her bow. She pulled the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. The band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this.
Sleepovers at Grandma and Grandpa's, you know. And about a week before Christmas, and we put them to bed, and Grandma said, "Say your prayers," and so they were up there kneeling down saying their prayers, and he said, "I pray for a bicycle." "I pray for a bicycle," about three times that loud, and finally Rebecca says, "Patrick, God isn't deaf." He said, "I know, but Grandpa is." So last summer I got hearing aids. And what I did is they've been after me for a while, you know. You're not hearing everything, Grandpa, Dad. So I went out and secretly had my ears tested and got a pair of aids. And I wore them for a month or so, and when I went back to the hearing lady to get them checked and do my evaluation, how everything's working, she said, "How are they working?" Oh, I said, "They're great. I love them." And she said, "What does the family think about them?" I said, "Well, I haven't told them." But I changed my will three times. Lost the little red dress.
I was going to ask you if I'm in your will.
You could be.
Oh,
how many years left.
I was thinking we could do a little bit of step dancing together.
You want to get rid of me quicker?
So we're going to do a French-Canadian fiddle number, and in Quebec especially, we, not that I'm from Quebec, but I grew up playing a lot of Quebec tunes, and...
We stand up or sit down?
We stay sitting, so everyone can do it.
Well, so I'd be bilingual after this.
With your right foot, we go front.
Thank you.
titled Lindsay's Request, and that was written and performed by our star, Stephanie. And Lindsay happens to be her grandfather, who lives in Perth, Ontario. And they have Scottish ancestry going way back, as many of us do. A lot of people in Dáil have the Scottish background and names. And you know, the Scots gave us so much. This will be so after I do a little reading here, we're going to feature a little medley of Scottish traditional music. They gave us the bagpipes and the two tunes that came with them. They gave us oatmeal, curling, golf, scotch, and the limbo dance. That was the dance invented by a Scotsman trying to get into a pay toilet. Anyway, I found a little Scottish poem that I thought I'd share with you here. I am a wee little fairy on top of the Christmas tree. It's no job, I fancy. Well, how'd you like to be me? All tattered up with tinsel, it's enough to make you balk. And a couple of jaggy branches rammed up the back of your frock. And these wee lights haroon me. I canna get my sleep. And there's the yearly visit from Santa, big fat creep. On Christmas Day, I'm stuck up here while you're ringing in. And nobody says, hey, you up there, could you go a slug of gin? The Christmas tree's a bonny sight as the firelight softly flickers. But think of me, I'm stuck up here with needles in my knickers.
Thank you.
place was Ireland. The time was a time of strife. This song tells the story of our aged and aging father, close to death, who had already lost two sons to war. As he says farewell to his third and youngest son, Danny Boy.
Oh, Danny Boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen, and down the mountainside, the summer's gone. Tis you must go, and I must die.
Street, and right now uptown Waterloo is bustling because the construction has been opened up and the traffic and the shoppers are back. And in the hustle and bustle of Christmas shopping, a lady lost her handbag. And a dear little innocent boy from uptown Waterloo found it and returned it. And she was so thankful, and when she opened her purse, she said, there's just one thing. She said, there was a $100 bill in there, and now there's a 50, two 20s, and a 10. He said, yeah, the last time I found a lady's handbag, she didn't have change for a quarter. A little kid, I remember putting records on our old hi-fi made by Electrohome, and we used to have a stack of records at Christmas time, and two of my favorites were Nat King Cole and Johnny Mathis, and this next carol we're about to hear became one of my absolute very favorite carols and has now been covered by thousands of artists all over the world. Oh Holy Night.
Yeah.
even puff. You remember the old Bible story at this time of year, the star in the east and the stable, and the three wise men. And my older sister, retired teacher, she said, wonder what would have been happened had there been three wise women instead of wise men. She said, well, the women would have asked directions and arrived on time. Probably would have helped deliver the baby. They'd cleaned the stable, they'd made a casserole, and they brought practical gifts like diapers. Never know. We have three wise men that I'd like to acknowledge now that helped us put this show together in short order. Our three techs, if you would, let's hear it for our lighting magician, Jeff Johnson Collins. Tech wizard with a new soundboard back there, Dylan Stahl. Backstage, everything running back here is handled by the talented Lyle Franklin. And I can't forget we have one wise woman up there on the shelf with the follow spot, Emily Maxwell. I'd like you to meet the star of our show, the lady who makes it all happen, Stephanie Cadman, who has a few more introductions.
Let's hear it for Neil. Yeah. I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank everyone at Drayton, cast and creative, who let us put this show together in such a short amount of time. And we've got one more tonight, which we're so grateful for. And I'm just blown away by everyone's talent on this stage with me. And I want to introduce you to the beautiful gal who actually came home 2 weeks early from Ireland. She's studying music there this year. And she came home just to be part of the show. This is Emily Flatt. Charts and arrangements tonight. Good friend of mine, Charles G. On drums, we have my longtime buddy, David McDougall. And from Stratford, Ontario, you may have seen him part of the Stratford Festival this summer. This is Kyle Waymount. The Bala family, which I'm sure a lot of you know. This is Devin Bala. Thanks so much for coming tonight. We're going to end with one more thing.
That is a Celtic Christmas, but it wouldn't be complete without a little sing-along. So you've had your little inserts in your programs. Let's see how we do. I want to hear harmonies. Sorry, I've wakened up a couple. But this is the time now. Sing along with us as we do. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Let it be true.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year. Oh, bring us some figgy pudding. Oh, bring us some figgy pudding. Oh, bring us some figgy pudding and a cup of good cheer. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year. We won't go until we get some. We won't go until we get some. We won't go until we get some. So bring it right here. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year. We all like a figgy pudding. We all like a figgy pudding. We all like a figgy pudding. And a cup of good cheer. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.